Hey everyone, how's it going? Mauter Tone's new wonder weapon, the Cerberus, has four different variants, but not all of them were created equal. So in today's video, I'll be ranking all four variants from worst to best based on how they handle standard hordes, boss zombies, and high rounds. Starting with the worst version, we have the Blazer mod, which shoots a steady laser similar to the DIE Electrobolt variant of the machine's Wonder Weapon. The Electrobolt is often considered one of the best variants of that Wonder Weapon, so it might be a little surprising to see what is essentially a clone of that Wonder Weapon at the bottom of this list. But there are a few key differences that make the Blazer mod worse. Firstly, this variant has basically no ammo. You run out of ammo extremely quickly with this mod. It's worth mentioning that every variant of the Cerberus could use at least twice as much ammo in my opinion, but it hurts this version the most because it has zero penetration power. Every variant of the Cerberus does the same amount of damage per shot, but some variants can hit more than one zombie with each shot. If more zombies get hit with a single shot, then you can do more damage to more zombies and make the most of the weapon's low ammo supply. The Blazer mod physically cannot hit more than one zombie at a time, and unlike the DIE Electrobolt, it doesn't get stronger with sustained fire. This results in a weapon that can only kill a couple of zombies before completely running out of ammo, which doesn't make it good for high rounds or boss zombies. If it weren't for the Easter egg step that requires this variant, I would never use it in my games. I would recommend you avoid this one if at all possible. Coming in at the number 3 spot is the Diffuser mod, which acts like a shotgun and looks suspiciously like the plasma cutter from Dead Space. Seriously, they look exactly the same. The Diffuser acts just like a weaker version of the Sweeper from Mob of the Dead, and when I say weaker, I mean weaker. This variant is more or less done with taking out hordes by round 30 or 40, so don't expect it to carry you to high rounds. It can still be useful at getting a single zombie out of your way while training, and it is decent at taking out mini bosses like the Manglers and Disciples, but it certainly doesn't outclass the Gallo or Hauer. And with Mule Kick in the game now, you can have both the Cerberus, the Ray Gun, and a shotgun that can fill that exact role. The Diffuser definitely has a role in the metagame, which is why I have it above the Blazer, but it's bested by weapons that are already in the game. It's definitely not unusable, but it's one that I have a hard time recommending for those reasons. At the number 2 spot, we have the Swarm mod, which is a handheld rocket launcher with surprisingly good lock-on capabilities. This is where the list breaks from variants that are just okay to the ones that are actually worth using. The Swarm holds up really well for high rounds. I had no issues using this well past the zombie's health cap, and didn't have any issues taking out hordes, manglers, disciples, or even the panzers. Granted, your train has to be grouped up pretty tightly to get the most out of this one, but aside from that, I can't really find anything to complain about with this one. This is the only variant of the base Wonder Weapon that I can actually recommend using in your game. But speaking of the base version, the number 1 spot is going to be taken up by that base version. It is a fully automatic pistol with a fast yet controllable fire rate and has by far the best penetration power of the bunch. The base version is exceptional at taking out hordes, whether they're in a line or in a tight pack, as well as every type of mini boss on the map. It struggles a little bit with the panzers since they're so bulky, but it's in line with the other version, and it also does extremely well in high rounds. It never took more than one or two shots to take out a zombie, which is in line with the Ray K84 from Firebase Z. The biggest issue I have with the base version is just how low the ammo count is. You can replenish your ammo by consistently swapping between variants that zombies will drop after being killed, but again, there's only one other variant of the Wonder Weapon that I would consider usable in most situations, so there's definitely times where ammo is an issue. Also, the Ray Gun is far better than any version of the Cerberus, so there's definitely cause for this weapon to be buffed sometime soon. If that happens, I'll have an updated list as a pinned comment on the video, so check it out if you're watching sometime in the future. But that's gonna be it for me in this video. Let me know what you think of this ranking and leave your own down in the comments below. Thanks for watching, like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.